So I said I will show you also the process on an example and a live one. I was just talking to some friends, three girls who would like to create a craft soap and cosmetics brand, mainly for an online shop, and the target group is consisting of women between age of 18 and 60, and also they want to reach out for men, obviously, through the women. So probably women gonna buy products for their partners. And it will be first a small web shop. So I have to make just a logo for the web shop and then packaging and branding later on. But now we just started a simple logo. The name of the brand is Verbena. And now I will show you how I usually start the research. We are in this amazing age of the internet, and Google is everywhere and all the other places. And first of all, I want to say this is just how I start. I work much more on the research part, and don't just search online. Also talk to people. If you, for example, if you know someone who is a herbalist, in this case I know my clients, I gonna definitely ask them, like, show me this plant, or what are you doing, how is the process going. I want to understand more about the product, more about their services, so I can take a look in the books about herbs and herbal plants and craft soap making, etc, etc. So what I mean, don't just hit up Google and type in, okay, I want a logo for herbal soaps. That's also a very important step, but not the only one. Okay, so what I do is, yeah, I type in the name in Google. And as I said in the research part, I am looking for the topic. So I'm researching the name because it can give me good ideas. I didn't know how Verbena looks, and I didn't know that it has about, it's not just one plant, it has about 250 different species. Most of them on the end of different colors and different shades of pink, purple and violet. This image looks extremely nice, and it's also connected to vampires. Okay. You see, this is what I do when I'm researching. I'm taking little notes, and I can totally lose myself in this part of the research, but it's okay. You can let yourself go a bit, because you never know where you find inspiration. So I look up the topic first, and I look up what other people are doing in this niche. And for that, I go to Behance. Behance.net, as you might know, is a big portfolio site where graphic designers, as myself and probably yourself, can upload your products and show off. And we can talk about it, we can discuss it. And then I just added a search for craft soap, and I can go around and see what people are creating and how they are differentiating their products. And as you can see, there are a lot of earth colors, and I love this one, and I know because it's three young ladies, and their target group is also women in their age. They would love something like this handcrafted illustration included in the logo. This type could be one of the logos, because as you will see, I'm always giving different variations to the client. Not a lot, but just a few. I will talk about this later. So this one could be a good type of logo, like a handcrafted illustration. I will really much think about it, because you have to balance the illustration and the simplicity of the logo. So the logo has to be simple and understandable, but still illustrative. We will see how much ornament it can take. So I can go around Behance a lot, and this is what I also do. I usually check out also Dribbble, and I take a lot of time. And again, I'm saying I'm not looking for anything to steal. I'm not looking anything to copy. If I have a great idea, like, okay, this is what it's gonna be, I'm checking it immediately if someone else already made it. If they made it, it's off limits for me. I'm sorry I'm talking about this much, but You will see it's very, very important. And the third place I usually hit up to continue my search, and it's exactly because of the reason I said previously, is I go to logopond.com, or I go to Logomuse, or I don't know, there are several pages like this, like Logospire, Logofavor, a lot websites which are logo galleries, where designers can show off only logo design work. And it is a great place to collect also inspiration and to see what people have done before, what they didn't do yet, what inspires you, what you can find. For example, I've just typed in on the top flower design, flower logos. And this logo is very nice, if you see it. And a lot of them is removed, or I don't know. Ah, this one. This one is also ornamental, but much cleaner. So maybe I would go towards this direction. And I don't mean copy the work of this designer. I really appreciate this work. I will not copy it. It's just a good direction to go. It has a nice circular shape. It has a good vibe. And it has a floral vibe, which is also working together with the name Verbena. If I go back, in my mind, it's already something coming up from all the research, and this is why we do the research, guys, is that I want to implement the name, the color, and the whole feel of this type of plants, like these images, and look at this photo, it's beautiful. So I want to implement this one and combine with a logo like this one, which I was showing, this ornamental logo. So research in logo design has to be gathering informations, but it has to be gathering inspiration, I would say more. So whatever inspires you and whatever is helping you to come up with great logo ideas, that's the part of the research. Take it like you are filling up your tank with different ideas, so later on you have all the gas to go on and create an amazing logo. And in the coming lessons, I will show you how.